Hi, I am Viktor, simulation specialist at PLM Group. In this video, I'll do a simple meshing and FEMRAP of a solid model on the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. All right, so I have the model open in the 3DEXPERIENCE interface. Let's check where it's open. It happens to be in the collaborative lifecycle app, and we are at the top level here. So to start the meshing, we need a FEMRAP. A FEMRAP can be created by right-clicking, insert, and then insert finite element model. There's an automatic way to do it, which can be done with another app. So we are on the top level. I'll go to the compass and I will use model assembly design. You can search for it here, but I'm just going to click it, model assembly design. Here we can also do that, right click, insert finite element model. Then we need to do things manually. In the tab here, we have automated FEM and we have the automated FEM button here. So I'm going to click that one. And here we can choose to create an empty one or use various user procedures or the existing procedures, or we can just use a standard. Note here that a material is already applied, so that's already done. I'm going to click standard. And then the tool asks us what we want to do. I want to do the mesh with the main body, but I can also, if I have an assembly, I can select which ones I want to include in the FEMRAP. No abstraction shape, that's a different topic. I want a tet mesh with, let's stick with the default parameters, which we'll talk about later. So I will click OK. And a FEMRAP is being created here and inserted under the top level. And this can be renamed by going into the properties if we want. So in fact, let's rename this. And let's name it something reasonable. Like so, and OK. So two things have been created. One is the solid section that links to the material and tells it that it's a solid, basically. So I'm going to double click down and check that it's on the part body, and it has the material, and I will pick the without plasticity behavior here, like so, and click OK. Then we have the tet mesh here, so I will double click this one, and here we can do more detailed settings or change the settings of the mesh if we want. So we can choose between first and second order elements. We can choose how to constrain the mid-side nodes of the second order elements. We can initialize the element size from the geometry, so it picks based on the various thicknesses and radiuses. So let's see what we get. So I'm going to click on the initialize from geometry button, and then I will click mesh and see what we get. So yeah, that's what we get. And here we can add local refinements and change the settings. So I'm going to try and see what happens without the mid-side nodes. Let's check around the holes here what's going on. So if I uncheck the mid-side nodes and remesh, I might get this effect so that it's not very well conforming to the hole. So let's use that one. Let's use the checkbox. And in some cases, you might get a warning here. Some boundary edges have been straightened. So we're going to take a look and see what those are. So I'm going to close this one and I'm just going to click OK. Then I can show this one by right-clicking and doing Hide Show. And then there are some edges here that are straight, which we can see here. So it's not a nice fillet. So the element size, the element edges have been straightened. So here it's also clear. So we need to fix this to have a really good mesh. So we can hide this one again. And we double click on the mesh to go back in here, and then we can adjust the settings. So let's go with an element size of 5 millimeters, and here the sag, so that's the deviation of the mesh from the geometry. We can have a very small value here, so maybe 0.1 and mesh. So this is a very crude way to refine your mesh, because we have no control over the element size, but it will anyway refine in the end, the result will be that it refines in fillets and where we have radiuses and curves. In this case, we still get this warning here. It might not be a big deal, but it's something that we can check. So let's do that. Okay, and I'm gonna double click on this one. We get the warning, and then we can find the symbol. Yeah, it's here. So it's one of the holes here. Yeah, and maybe here as well. Okay. So like I said, this sag parameter in the tet mesh here is a very crude way. So it's a very crude way to refine your elements. So it's better to rely on the local refinements and local specifications, which we have here. So the first one is the local mesh size. This is the most straightforward one. So I'm going to click that one, and then we'll define a local one. So I'm going to put this one in all the fillets. So this one, this, here, 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 here. And if it's hard to click here, we can hide the mesh so we are sure we click right on the geometry. And that we do with the visibility manager. Okay. And I will hide all the FE models, all the FEMREPs. And then sometimes it's easier to get hold of the geometry here. And a size of 1.5 millimeter, click OK. That one will exist here, where we can find it again if we want to change it. Now we can mesh. Where is the mesh? Well, we need to actually show it, so I'm going to click here, show all, or show contributing. And now we have the refinements here, because of our local specification. Okay. Should also add something here so we can have several local specifications at the same time. So let's do this one. So this one and maybe this one as well. Okay, and mesh. Now we didn't get the warning, and we have two local specifications here. There is another one which is called fillet specification, which is also nice. Here we define the number of layers. So I'm going to put that one here on the back to try. So the number of layers could be 5 with a maximum aspect ratio of 2. So the shape of the element. Click OK, and then I will click on mesh. What sometimes happens there is this effect that you get very fine on the surface, so on the fillet itself, but the element shape will be pretty bad because you don't have the same refinement behind it. And there is a very sharp transition here from fine to coarse. So this one you need to be a bit careful with. I'm gonna use 2 layers here instead. That makes more sense. And remesh. And there we are. Okay. So by adding some local specifications, we can get a mesh that's fine. And click OK. How fine is it? Well, we can go to the check tab down here in the action bar, check, and use the quality analysis. So I'm going to click that one. And then we can get an idea of how fine the elements are. So I'm going to hide the shape here, just so it's everything is green. And all the elements have an aspect ratio that is on the average 1.7. The worst one is about 4. Which happens to be this one. So then we know that. So then you can judge your element quality or your mesh quality based on these parameters. How are these defined? Well, they can be changed here in the criteria editor. So here are all the ways in which the quality criteria can be adjusted. We want to be really strict. Maybe we want a warning if the aspect ratio is more than 3, so I can apply, and then all of a sudden we have 72 elements that violate this, this information changes a bit. So I'm going to restore the criteria to 5 and apply, and then it's back to 0 poor elements according to these criteria. Okay. And with the visibility manager, we can hide everything if we want, and then we can show only the contributing shapes and show the contributing FE models. What does it mean that it's contributing? Well, in the setup tab here, in the action bar, there's the contributing shapes manager. So I'm clicking that one. And here, if I have an assembly or if I have many 3D shapes here in the same part, for some reason, here I can choose which ones are, well, contributing. So we have the mesh, we have some local specifications, and we have the solid section with the applied material. Then I will run an update, which is also a way to remesh the model if the mesh is not up to date. So I click Ctrl U or click the update button down here on the action bar. When that is done, looks good, I will save. Ctrl S or go up here and save it in the top right. And there we go. Now we're ready for the simulation setup. Thanks for watching.